Morning.
Hello, everyone. Can you imagine how your life would be without access to electricity? Unfortunately, this is the reality for many people living in third world countries such as Kenya. With your investment of $1 million, we plan on changing this unfortunate reality by building a hydroelectric power plant in Kenya. We believe that it would be most opportune to construct the hydroelectric power plant on the Tana River, as it is the largest river in Kenya. To specify, the Tana River is approximately 800 kilometers long, and 5,000 cubic megameters of water flows through it annually to the Indian Ocean, passing several towns and villages on its way. So, as you can see, this river affects a large population of Kenya, which is why our research has found it to be the best location for a hydroelectric plant. We believe that it is important to not only to use the money to help those in need, but by doing so, the results could help our living conditions and the entire world in the long run. In order to improve the quality of the world as a whole, in terms of living conditions, we must first start by helping those in need. Since we live in an area where access to power isn't an issue, we've seen firsthand how it can benefit society. With access to a power plant or to a power source, businesses would have access to better tools and technology. It would improve the living conditions of the individuals, and finally, the benefits to the surrounding area would greatly increase.
Water at the higher level is collected in the forebay. It flows through the plant intake into a pipe called a penstock, which carries it down to a turbine water wheel at the lower water level. The water pressure increases as it flows down the penstock. It is this pressure and flow that drives the turbine that is connected to the generator. Inside the generator is the rotor that is spun by the turbine.
Large electromagnets are attached to the rotor, located within coils of copper wire called a stator. As the generator rotor spins the magnets, a flow of electrons is created in the coils of the stator.
This produces electricity that can be stepped up in voltage through the station transformers and sent across transmission lines. The falling water, having served its purpose, exits the generating station to the tail race, where it rejoins the mainstream of the river to continue the cycle of creating clean, renewable energy for Ontario.
Now that we've talked about the general points, John will discuss how businesses could benefit from the electricity provided by hydroelectric power plant.
Businesses will have a reliable and affordable power supply to further promote expansion. Can any of you imagine a business such as Coca-Cola solely running off just paper and pen without any access to electricity? In order to continue their volume and production, they would need to hire several times the amount of workers they currently have for a consistent level of production without the help of machine power. In addition to their increase in manpower and lack of machines, they would need to build a much larger facility to provide enough space for production and bottling. To make matters even worse, the workday would only last as long as sunlight was available to the lack of lighting without electricity. With better access to power, Kenya will be closer to their goal of reaching the same league as a group known as the Asian Dragons. This would mean that Kenya and its businesses would reach a similar economic level as those in Singapore, South Korea, Hong Kong, and Taiwan. According to UCSUSA.org, renewable energy projects keep money circulating within the local economy, and in most states, renewable electricity production would reduce the need to spend money on importing coal and natural gases from countries as far away as Colombia and Indonesia. Renewable energy provided from hydroelectric power plants and similar sources have been shown to be even more beneficial to companies, as the cost of electricity would remain consistent, meaning companies would not have to worry about fluctuating utility costs during production. Now that you have been informed of the benefits of electricity and its role in local businesses, you can better understand why it is important that we receive your investment of $1 million in hopes of creating a hydroelectric power plant in the country of Kenya. Furthermore, now that we have helped you to understand how building a hydroelectric power plant in Kenya will affect business growth, it's time for Leo to talk about the benefits that the individual citizens will receive from this.
With the help of a constant supply of electricity, the individuals surrounding the power plant would benefit by having access to a greatly increased quality of life. For instance, when you have electricity, you can use a computer. When you can use a computer, you have access to the internet. When you have access to the internet, you have access to the world. Along with this, the average individual would be able to use power tools, which in turn would allow them to more easily build larger structures such as houses. Could you imagine how your day would be without electricity? Chances are you probably wake up each morning using an alarm clock. Without electricity, this would be much harder as you'd rely entirely on the sun or on your natural instincts. Think of something as basic as air conditioning. Can you imagine how you'd be every day during the summer or winter if you didn't have the ability to change the temperature within your own home? In addition to the daily tasks that require electricity you go through, think about how important it is to have clean running water as well. With the help of our hydroelectric power plant, the individual would have much easier access to purified water, which would be available in the Kenyans' houses through many ways, including the ability to have refrigerators in the Kenyans' houses, which not only purifies water using water filters, but only helps store food for longer periods of time. Along with the health benefits of having purified running water, hospitals would have access to much better equipment that runs on electricity. This would allow larger health centers to be built as well, as a constant source of energy would be available, meaning machines such as heart monitors and surgical equipment could be powered at all times. This, in turn, would affect the average lifespan of the local Kenyans. If you're not convinced yet, we believe that having access to electricity, Kenyans would have access to a greater supply of food due to farms being able to process food and having automated irrigation systems, thus solving some of the hunger problems within Kenya. With this in mind, we believe that with your $1 million, we will be able to create the hydroelectric power plant, thus greatly increasing the individual's average life in Kenya. Lastly, understanding the benefits towards businesses and individuals, Woody will inform you of why a hydroelectric power plant would also have a significant impact on the surrounding environment.
Hydroelectric power plants have been known to have a unique impact on the environment. In addition to helping out individuals and businesses, hydroelectric power plants have been known to help out the wildlife and the surrounding area. Other power sources don't have any direct benefits to the environment, but only cause harm. For example, nuclear power plants are required to be near a water source for cooling. The water is exposed to toxic chemicals, which can harm the wildlife. Wind turbines require large tracts of land and significant amounts of maintenance to operate. Land used by wind turbines can't be used for other purposes, like farming. As stated earlier, hydroelectric power plants are made up of dams and turbines. This creates a lake above the dam. This can help prevent flooding below the dam because the dam can control the flow rate of the water. According to BrightHub.com, the fish in the river could start populating in the lake, which would be beneficial to local fishermen. Hydroelectric power plants do not produce any waste and are known to be a very green power source. Other power sources can burn fossil fuels, like coal, that lead to harmful chemicals in the atmosphere. According to water.usgs.gov, fossil fuel burning power plants can also harm other areas because of the extraction process, like strip mining for coal, which brings other harmful chemicals into the area near the mine. A hydroelectric power plant can last for more than 100 years, so after the initial construction and filling of the reservoir, no further disruption needs to occur to the environment. Any construction process is going to have some disruption, but because the hydroelectric power plant requires little maintenance, after it's constructed, their environment can thrive around it. We believe that with your investment of $1 million, we would be able to help not only the individuals and businesses around the power plant, but also the environment.
Thank you, Woody. In conclusion, after discussing all the benefits of your investment toward our hydroelectric power plant, we believe that with the $1 million, we would be able to put that towards a great cause. With access to a power source, businesses would have better access to tools and technology. It would improve the living conditions of the individuals. And finally, the benefits in the surrounding area environment would greatly increase. To quote World Watch Institute, Africa produces the least hydropower, accounting for 3% of the world total. But it is considered the region with the greatest potential for increased production. According to hydrofoundation.org, $1 million would be able to build a hydroelectric power plant capable of producing 500 kilowatts of energy. Remember, with your investment, we can greatly benefit the lives of hundreds of thousands of Kenyans, which would lead them to merge into a developed country. My name is Connor Allen.
My name is Leo Vanderman.
My name is Woody McClain.
I'm John Lyle. Thank you for your time.